This video will be about the powerful technique called cross-site request forgery, CSRF. In the last video, we have explored XSS, cross-site scripting, which allows us to execute JavaScript in the context of a user's session. This allows us to perform any actions the user could do. Thus, we can use it to send messages to other users on the platform without the victim noticing or injecting fake news article into a site or simply defacing it. But if a site implemented user input securely, properly escapes the strings, then you are out of luck. One might wonder why you cannot simply run JavaScript on your own site that you control and perform the same requests and actions. Well, the security model of the browser prevents that. This security model is called the SameOrigin Policy. Whatever is running on my lifeoverflow.com domain is not allowed to access resources cross-origin. You will get an error. But wait, that doesn't make any sense. How can the Reddit domain access resources, namely images, from this other origin, imgur.com? Does that not violate the SameOrigin Policy? You are so smart for asking this question. The SameOrigin Policy is obviously a little bit more complex, and there are a lot of different cases you have to consider. Let's do some examples so you just see how diverse it is. I'm here on Reddit. It has the origin https://reddit.com. Over here I have https://imgur.com. So on Reddit I can easily use an HTML image tag and load the image resource. As you can see, the browser did the request without complaining. On Reddit, you can get a lot of data in JSON format. That's a neat trick if you didn't know about that. Question: can imgur.com access those JSON responses? It's a simple GET request, like the image, right? And we are able to display the image, so we should be able to get the content of this request as well. We can use XML HTTP request to perform a GET request. Looks like it worked, but the response is empty JSON. And it doesn't contain the data we expected. Let's have a look at the network tab to see what happened. We first notice there is more than one simple request. The first one here got a response from the Reddit server with a location header. The browser receiving this header will now perform a redirect to this new location, and this new location is /login. Ah, that makes sense. When we look closely, we don't see any cookies being sent along with this request, like it did when we simply opened this URL on Reddit. A quick Google search will tell you that you can include the cookies by setting with credentials to true before sending the request. But nope, now it doesn't work. Now the browser complains that you are violating the SameOrigin Policy. The domain imgur.com is not allowed to perform a GET request to reddit.com with cookies. This makes it kinda useless for an attack, because as an attacker we would like to extract private user data, but without the cookies it will never contain private stuff. Let's try something else. Let's use an image tag like earlier and load this .json file. We look into the network tab and what the fuck, it did send the cookies with this request. So did we just find a bypass to the SameOrigin Policy? Well, no. You see, we can't access the response of this request. We cannot access the JSON content, thus we cannot access the private user data. Okay, so it looks like the SameOrigin Policy is pretty good. It prevents us from accessing private data cross origins. Of course, there are some technical possibilities to loosen up this policy, and Chrome even tells you about it in the error message. With this special response header that could be set by the Reddit server, this could be allowed. But one thing is still fishy. With the image source, we just performed an authenticated, meaning cookies were included, request to the other domain. We don't get the response, but could this still be exploited in a meaningful way? Yes, it can. Let's see. You remember the different HTTP methods, like GET and POST. Generally, GET requests are intended to fetch to get a resource, and nothing else. While POST requests potentially change a user's data. So performing an authenticated GET request should generally be safe, except when a site is developed badly and a URL is accessible via GET performs an actual action. If that is the case, you have found your first cross-site request forgery CSRF vulnerability. So if there is, for example, a URL that deletes a user like profile delete, you embed that as an image on your website, then every user visiting your site will delete their profile without them noticing it. Okay, but let's say the developer follows this design and there are no state-changing GET requests. Is the site safe? Well, here's another technique for POST request. I can create a form with the method POST and the action aiming at the other domain, and when we submit the form, it will perform a POST request with the cookies. So yes, we can perform an authenticated POST request as well. So the site also redirects to the new other domain, but we can hide that from the user or don't care, because the attack then is over anyway. But how do I get a user to click? Well, a user doesn't have to click, you can simply auto-submit this form with JavaScript. Just to make it clear, the SameOrigin policy is not violated here, because our origin does not get to access the resources, the response, the data of this other domain. So how do we protect from this kind of attack? One approach would be to compare a legitimate request from our domain with an illegitimate request from another domain and see if there are any differences that we could check for. And yeah, we could check for the origin header, which is definitely different. This might sound like a good idea. It certainly prevents some kind of cross-site request forgery attacks. But for example, sites like forums allow users to embed their own pictures, and if this forum is vulnerable to a GET CSRF attack, then users could simply embed that URL as an image into a message, and then the request would come from the same domain. So this is not a bulletproof protection. There are also some kind of mitigations, for example, form POST requests always send the data URL encoded. And you may have found this old Stack Exchange thread telling you that a cross-domain request with the content type JSON is impossible, and your endpoint could only accept JSON data, and this might prevent some noobs from exploiting it. But your trust into this protection is flawed. Down here in the hidden, in a comment, you find information about a trick using Navigator Send Beacon. It's a super awesome trick, and little tricks like that make the difference between a normal web penetration tester and a great one. Anyhow, as you can see, this is also not bulletproof. So then what can we do? The solution is called CSRF token. CSRF tokens can be implemented in a few different ways, but generally you want a secret random value to be set by the server in a way that it's only accessible to the website running on the same domain. And this secret value has to be included in every POST request to the server. Otherwise, it will refuse to react to the request. And that works, because the SameOrigin policy prevents other domains accessing your data, thus cannot get the secret CSRF token, but the legit domain can. Obviously, if you find a way to leak the CSRF token, then you defeat the CSRF protection. Now, this token doesn't have to change with every request, but the idea is that it's hard to predict, so it shouldn't be valid forever. Also, very, very important, CSRF tokens have to be bound to your user's session. Otherwise, I could, for example, collect valid CSRF tokens with one account and use them in a CSRF attack against other accounts. Cross-site request forgery can be extremely powerful, and bypassing a weak CSRF protection can be super fun. But make no mistake, just because a website has a vulnerable endpoint doesn't mean it's a critical issue. But before we finish here, I want to simulate your creativity a little bit by giving you an example in how you can turn a few low severity bugs into a cool attack. Here's the recipe. First low severity issue is a stored self-XSS vulnerability. Self-XSS means that we can inject a JavaScript payload into a website, for example a personal notebook on that site, but it only affects our own user account. We can't trick anybody else in executing this JavaScript payload because we are the only one seeing our personal node. So it's useless, right? Or is it? Next issue is a lockout cross-site request forgery. This allows us to lock out anybody visiting our evil page. The last issue is a login cross-site request forgery. So this allows us to send the login credentials to authenticate with that website. But what the hell would we use that for? Well, here's our attack plan. First, we create a new account and add the self-XSS. Maybe the payload can create a fake login prompt telling the user to re-enter their password so we can steal it. Then we build an attack site that will execute the following two things in order. First, it will make sure the victim is not logged into the site by using the lockout CSRF. and then we perform a login CSRF with the account credentials of our self-accessed account. Now we simply have to redirect the victim back to the site, and the victim will be authenticated with our account executing the self-access, asking for the password. Beautiful phishing attack.